cues create specific motor patterns and they create certain sequential muscle action. So you gotta be careful with your cues. Are you making some of these simple mistakes? Here's a new way to think about cues and we're gonna talk about it in this video, so check it out. Everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Airtay Throws Nation. In today's video, what we're gonna talk about are cues. Cues are super important for a couple reasons, and at the end of this video, we're gonna have a link where you can get a download sheet on some cues and some of the muscle functions that they create. Now, here's the key thing. What's difficult about coaching throwing is that I can have 10 athletes lined up. You know, one cue will not work for all 10. That's the thing. So one of the things that we're always trying to teach and what we focus on with the throwing chain reaction system is we're breaking down the pillars and we're training those motor patterns. That's the point of the pillars, is to be able to teach everybody how to move in those motor patterns. Cues create specific muscle sequencing. So, preseason throws camps are kicking off here in the US. Click the link below for information for this camp and upcoming camps. You're really gonna love the changes. New camp format, really cool. We'll see you there. For example, one of the things we're gonna talk about is that one of the common cues as a throws coach, you wanna make sure that your athletes will land on the ball of the foot in the middle, and they're gonna keep rotating around and they're gonna hitch what we call our pillar 4, 5, 6. And so you're gonna be moving into that power position and coming through. Now, one of the things that's gonna be a detriment, of course, we've talked about, is if you drop the heel rotational stop, you'll create this lateral shift. The upper body catches up to the lower body, and then you're losing that acceleration ability, which creates those big distances. Now, one of the common cues is to tell people, get your heel up. One of the things is, I'll talk about that, and we'll go to camps and we'll teach where we want the position of the heel and how we want it to stay up so that we can keep rotating on it, and that's correct. One thing we'll say is, I'll have some coaches and common things they'll say, you know, I've been explaining this, I've been telling the athlete that same thing. And what we're trying to explain in this video is that you're not always explaining the same thing. You can be saying two things that seem very much alike, which are going to create two different muscle actions, and those muscle actions are going to create different movement patterns in the throw. So for example, as we're discussing, as I'm coming in and we're teaching athletes how to stay on the ball of their foot. Now this is going to have to do with angles and high point and all those sorts of things that we go in depth on and we teach inside of our throwing chain reaction. The thing that we're trying to do is, when we stay on the ball of the foot, the angle matters, but what happens is an overcorrection sometimes, and you'll hear a coach say, keep your heel up. That is a cue I used to use, and what you have to realize is that when you tell an athlete, keep the heel up, you're creating plantar flexion, so you're shortening the calf. A short flexed calf isn't going to load the same as not dropping the heel. So you notice when I say don't drop the heel, I'm going to load through the hips and the quads more. I'm going to stay on the ball. I'm going to keep that calf basically in an eccentric position that's going to be able to allow the thrower to drive through. And you're going to notice how I'm maintaining contact to the ground, creating power, and I'm going to be able to keep that hip ahead of the shoulder through the delivery, which is exactly what we're going to want to have happen. All cues are absolutely not created equal. It's super important to realize that. What we're going to do is, we have a lot of common cues, and so we created a checklist and a link in the description, and you can download a 5 of our most common cues and the muscle sequences and why they're more effective than using common cues, which again, like in this example, is keeping the heel up versus don't letting the heel drop. Two different sequences of muscle activation, therefore you're gonna get two different outcomes, and that's one of the reasons why throwing is so difficult. Okay guys, thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next video. What are some of the fundamentals that really help the rotational shot? And one of the core things is to understand that, of course, we have a smaller ring, the ball is sitting on top of us,